Welcome back to Grow with Angie. This is the third and final video in this mini series of harvesting the iHarvest, tearing it down and setting it back up. And now today, I'm gonna experiment with a new plant and a new growing process. And we're gonna do this experiment together. If you're ready, I'm ready to dive in and let's see what's going on inside this bag. I decided I wanted to grow strawberries. I'm gonna do an entire unit of only strawberries. But growing them from seed can be very difficult. It can take a long time for them to germinate. Some seeds work, some don't. By the time you get to a flowering process or actual strawberries, it can be months and months. So what would be better than actually getting bare root strawberries? And they look like this. They are literally bare root. And there is little strawberry buds at the top, so they're already at that process. And we're gonna take them from this to an amazing unit of strawberries. Some of you might be wondering, where would you purchase such a thing? Well, surprisingly, you can get them off of Amazon. And after a lot of research and kind of digging around a little bit, I ended up purchasing these from a company called the Hand-Picked Nursery. Now, what I thought was really cool about this is they are a veteran-owned business. So for me, I like to support that. And it was from North Carolina. As soon as you get them, either decide to start washing them or put them in a refrigerator. Because I spent the day yesterday cleaning the units and exhausting myself, I did put these in the refrigerator last night. Now there's a couple of different types of strawberries that you could look for. One of them is called June bearing, and they are only going to produce strawberries once a year. So it could be a lot of work to only get one harvest from them. Ever-bearing strawberries, which these are, can produce 2 to 3 cycles of strawberries. Growing them hydroponically and having your pH levels and your EC levels at a perfect range, having your house temperature where it needs to be between 65 and 75, you could potentially get more harvest out of these types of strawberries, and they work really well with hydroponics. Day neutral strawberries are your third choice. Day neutral are not as particular when it comes to how much light they need. But I chose the ever-bearing because the more research I did, it seemed like it was the most widely used for hydroponics. These are gonna want between 12 to 16 hours. I'm gonna keep them about 14 hours, which is what my lights normally are set to. But how are we going to get this into here? And what is the process? Let's walk through kind of what I have in my head. We'll get these set up and then we'll start filling the tanks on the units and we'll balance out the pH and the EC. So stick around for that and I'll give you the best numbers and information for growing your strawberries. One thing to know about bare root strawberries is they do actually come from soil. Because we're doing hydroponics, we don't want any soil in our system. I'm going to give these a good rinse and try and get as much of that soil off of them as possible. Now, another thing to note, I purchased a pack of 20. Because the unit that I'm using has 30 holes, I purchased 2 packs of these. They can be somewhat expensive compared to if you just bought a pack of seeds, but I don't have to wait for that whole seed germination process. I'm gonna go ahead and wash all of these, and then I'm gonna change out my water mixture to a water and hydrogen peroxide mixture. And what that's gonna do is help to get rid of any potential bug larva that might be on these because they were growing in soil and probably in some type of a greenhouse somewhere. This could be a little bit of a tedious thing, but I think if we take the time to do all of this now, we will have a better grow later. I'm gonna go ahead and wash up 30 of these, and then we will start with our hydrogen peroxide in water dip. I have 30 of them washed, and I ended up, out of the 40 that I ordered, I got 44. Now what we're gonna do is take this fresh water, and I'm gonna do a half a cup of hydrogen peroxide, and it's not gonna harm your plants. This is something that you can actually put in your hydroponic gardens to also help with any type of algae. And just kind of stir that up a little bit. And this is cool water. Strawberries do like to be cool. You can see how dirty this is getting even with all of that rinsing that I did. I have rapid rooters over here. These rapid rooters are floating in warm water. And the reason I do that is because I actually freeze my rapid rooters. Now, I've never had a bug problem come from the rapid rooter itself, but some companies have had problems with them in their warehouses, and if they ship them to you and there's bug larvae in there, then again, a bug problem. And that is still what came off the water even after a really good rinse. These are the net cups that actually come with the iHarvest, and they have the little green clips on them. I don't want to destroy them so much that I can't ever use them again. If I take out the bottom section, these are just gonna fall right through. I'm thinking I'm gonna go ahead and just remove a couple of these little bars in here. Then what I'm doing is creating a lot of space that I can then kind of weave the roots through. Now, with the holes, I should be able to take one of these and gently weave the roots through. And you know what? This is where my brain goes. This is how I come up with all these really crazy ideas. I'm a sewer, a crocheter, and a knitter. And I'm honestly thinking, if I went and grabbed one of my crochet hooks, this would be so much easier. Now, I'm being really crazy by doing 30 of these. You do not have to do a full unit. But I want to add some stability to this. If it's sitting this direction or in Kratcky, then the clay pebbles would work great. You could just jam them in there. But because of the units that I'm using and everything is tipped at an angle, I hate clay pebbles. People, listen, they will roll out on your floor and you'll come out and they'll be all over. And when you try and turn one, I do not want to be chasing clay pebbles. This is where my other thought comes in, and we're gonna see if it works. I do like to take my rapid rooters and I like to kind of rinse them off just because there's a lot of debris on the rapid rooter itself. And that's just another thing to like clog up my tank. I'm gonna take this rapid rooter and I'm gonna cut the thing right in half. And I'm literally going to use these as a stability. I'm gonna take one and I'm gonna shove it down on this side. And then I'm gonna take another one. Look at that, it worked perfect. We're gonna do another one, and I grab some crochet hooks. I'm just gonna be cutting this bottom section. And then I found if you keep your scissors there and flip it upward, then they're not flying all over the place. And I'm going to split the root. Then we'll grab the crochet hook. And I have two sizes, but look at how easy that is. I'm gonna go ahead and do 28 more of these. I'm gonna pop them into the units, and then I'm gonna start filling my tank with water, and we will talk about the pH and the ECs needed for your strawberries and get that unit running. So I'll see you in the flash of an edit. Now it's time to check the nutrients in the water, and we're gonna see where we are out of my faucet. Why aren't you working? It's not working. To be honest, I thought my Bluelab is broken or the batteries are bad. I mixed up some water, I threw some food in it, and it jumped all the way up. Lesson be learned, my EC right now is below 0.4 or below the 200 or 280 ppm. So I know that that is very low, and we definitely have to get some food in here. I want 1.0 to 1.4. I'm gonna go ahead and use my MaxiGrow, and I'm just gonna do one scoop on the bigger side. And then we'll go ahead and stir this up. And now my lights are working. Look at that. If your numbers are lower than the lights won't turn on. I'm gonna give it a little bit more of a stir. And now it's flashing between the 0.4 and the 0.6, so we're at 0.5. We're gonna add more. Love that I can stir with this thing. So now I'm jumping between 0.6 and 0.8, which means I'm blending at 0.7. Also, one of the things that will increase your nutrient level is items like CalMag, which is calcium, magnesium, and iron. We're also going to add that to the unit because strawberries do like calcium. You don't necessarily have to do this until you are really at the flowering stage, which I'm also going to be switching from a regular nutrient to a blooming nutrient. IG Works now has their own products and they do have a flower one. Probably going to use that over the Maxi Bloom and see if that makes any difference. So I'm going to do about 8 milliliters of the kale mag. And we're gonna stir that up and see if that does any difference to our food. I think what I'm gonna do definitely is let this run, let the roots kind of get settled into their new environment and slowly increase the food. Now, I'm also gonna add a little bit of hydrogen peroxide in case, like we did with the soak, there might be some larvae. This will also help oxygenate the roots and slow any algae that might wanna start, but we've got the reflective covers on, so I don't have a problem. You guys are all gonna laugh at me and be like, Angie, you're not measuring, what are you doing? No, I don't. I do a couple seconds of a squirt. Once you kind of do these, any type of hydroponics towers, you start to really learn what you're doing. Now that we have our pH, our kale mag, our hydrogen peroxide, and our maxi, I am going to crawl behind this unit and turn the thing back on. We are on. Okay, so I heard a little buzz kick on or a little vibration kick on, and that is the wave makers. Now that you all took this 3-video journey with me, I hope you learned something about harvesting, cleaning your hydroponics, and starting fresh. Sometimes it's sad to pull all of your plants out and you don't want to go through the process. But there's always something new to grow or something to save. Then I'm gonna decide what herbs we're gonna put in this other unit. It's always a new beginning. It's always a fresh start and it's okay. We can make mistakes. We can mess up the pH. We can mess up the nutrients. You can mess up the water timers. It's all right. Learn from your mistakes, continue to grow, and make sure you are subscribed to the channel so you can grow with Angie. Okay, I need to not be yelling.
That's exactly what I've been saying for a long time. We finally agree.